We warmly welcome you to the presentation on hardware interaction with programming languages. Throughout this presentation, we will make you aware of first and second generation languages with regard to the topic. For further details, please refer our blog langinhw.blogspot.com. Firstly, we would like to thank Mr. Lakmal Rupasinghe for the guidance he gave and also the group members who made this event a success. Programming languages are divided into two sections. They are low-level languages and high-level languages. Here we are considering only the first generation and second generation languages which come under low-level languages. These are some features of low-level languages. Machine dependent, can control the hardware precisely, consists of 0 or 1 only. Non-English like procedural languages can directly run by a computer. As we move on to the next slide, the diagram helps to visualize the hierarchy of low-level languages. The first language we are going to consider is Fortran. Fortran was introduced in 1953. This was an optimizing compiler because customers were reluctant to use a high-level programming language unless its compiler could generate code whose performance was comparable to that of hand-coded assembly language. By 1960, versions of Fortran were available for the IBM 709, 650, 1620 and 1790 computers. By 1963, over 40 Fortran compilers existed. Input devices were punch cards. The images show the punch card system used in Fortran. The initial release of Fortran for the IBM 704 contained 32 statements, including formatted IFTTT, format, read, read input date, write, write output date, print and punch. It also included unformatted IO, that means read date, read drum, write tape and write drum, followed by other IO, that means end file, rewind and backspace. When it comes to control statements, the control statement specifies the output to be produced. It must be the first statement of the source code. As shown here, STM, P1, P2, P3. STM is a free to use control statement, allowing the comma 1 to 3 parameters in any order, which define the output input. The control statement must be terminated by an end of statement mark. Spaces embedded in the statement are ignored. The parameters may be a combination of the following: binary output, list output and assembly list. Operating instructions. The exact operating procedures for a compilation depend on the available hardware configuration. The possible allocation of equipment might be as follows. If there are two output devices as shown above, there are two passes or parsers. The list output and an intermediate binary tape are both produced during the first pass. The assembly listing and the binary output are both produced during the last pass. If one output device is available, list output and intermediate binary output are written on the same tape during the first pass. That is, the compiler ignores the list output when reading the binary data during the second pass. The binary output is then produced in the next to the last pass, and the assembly listing is in the last pass. Simple Fortran loop program. This program for Heron's formula has one data card input with zero data edit check. If one of the input values is zero or negative, then the program will end with an error code of stop 1 in the job control card listing following the execution of the program. Normal output will be one line printed with A, B, Z, and area on the report page, allowing the compilation with no specific units or status, and with a normal stop in the job card listing. Starting in 1961, as a result of customer demand, IBM began development of a Fortran 4 that removed the machine-dependent features of Fortran 2, such as read input data, while adding new features such as a logical data type, logical Boolean expressions, and the logical if statements as alternative to the arithmetic if statement. And now we move on to the COBOL, which is also known as Common Business Oriented Language. Let's focus on another first generation language, that is COBOL, which is also known as Common Business Oriented Language. When it comes to history of COBOL, it was developed in 1959 and its first compiler was released in the same year. Since then, there had been several versions of COBOL with improvements. What made COBOL special? It was the first programming language developed for commercial application development. The problem is segmented into several tasks, which led COBOL to procedure-oriented language. Another feature COBOL had was its English-like language. This helped in great deal to learn, code, and maintain programs within COBOL. The COBOL program consists mainly of four divisions. They are Identification Division, Environment Division, Data Division, and Procedure Division. The Identification Division. This is the first division and the program is identified here. Program ID followed by the user-defined name is mandatory. All other paragraphs are optional and used for documentation. The length of user-defined name for IBM COBOL is 8. Second division is Environment Division. Only machine-dependent division of COBOL program. It supplies information about the hardware or computer equipment to be used on the program. When your program moves from one computer to another computer, the only section that may need to be changed is environment division. We will focus more on the section later. Then we have the data division. Data division is used to define the data that need to be accessed by the program. The data division is followed by the procedure division. This is the last division and business logic is coded here. It has user-defined sections and paragraphs. Section name should be unique within the program and the program name should be unique within the section. This is a sample code segment of a COBOL program. This includes the identification division and environment division.